Thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Kristen Carosa. It's another day of welcome rain here in New Hampshire, and our recent weather is starting to have some impact on our continuing drought. While the drought isn't over, conditions are getting better. The southern part of the state has been hardest hit, but significant rain over the past few weeks has made a huge difference. Just this past week, extreme drought conditions across the state shrunk from 19% down to under 5%. DES says this is good news, but they want to warn residents the drought will continue through the winter.
Usually, you know, we get the recharge in the fall and that will help to alleviate drought situations. But right now, we're going to be heading into the wintertime in a severe drought situation. And people need to understand that they need to conserve their groundwater because there's not going to be new recharge helping their wells.
DES urges anyone affected by the drought to visit their website where they have a survey to help track the needs across the state. Right now, the Department of Corrections is looking for an inmate who never returned to a transitional housing unit last night. 68-year-old William Roy is now on the walkaway status after he didn't return from an appointment. Roy was sentenced in 2014 for forgery. He's not eligible for release until September 2018. Roy is 5'8", 185 pounds, with brown eyes and brown hair. He walks with a cane. New this noon, police are looking for this man who they say exposed himself at a Dunkin' Donuts in Bradford. He's said to be in his late 20s or early 30s, around 6 feet tall, 185 to 210 pounds, with a brown hair or beard. He was last seen driving a black Chevy Silverado pickup truck. The retrial of convicted murderer Gary Sampson continues in federal court in Boston today. Sampson killed two men from Massachusetts and one man from New Hampshire back in 2001. He was handed the death sentence for the Massachusetts murders, but was later granted a new trial for his sentence only. The jury for his retrial will decide if Sampson gets life in prison without parole or the death penalty. The defense is arguing that Sampson had excessive head injuries growing up, which affected his decision making. Some of the victim's family members were in court during yesterday's opening statements. Republican Senator Kelly Ayotte and Democratic challenger Governor Maggie Hassan faced off last night in the second of our Granite State debates. Recent polls show the two are locked in a very close race. The candidates covered a wide range of issues during the debate, including cybersecurity, the drug crisis, and gun rights.
I appreciate so much how important it is that we keep guns away from criminals and terrorists. I also believe it's equally important that we stand up for the Second Amendment rights of our citizens.
We should be closing the loopholes in our background check system so that terrorists can't buy guns online and at gun shows. And even after the tragedy in Orlando, Senator Ayotte had the opportunity to vote to close those loopholes, and she has declined to do that.
Next question.
Neither Ayotte nor Hassan was willing to fully support their respective party's presidential nominee. The candidates did agree that there should be no U.S. ground troops in Iraq for the fight against ISIS. If you missed the debate, you can watch it right now on WMUR.com and on our mobile app. Our Granite State debates continue tonight with three candidates in the 1st Congressional District taking the stage. The latest WMUR Granite State poll has Democratic Carol Shea Porter ahead in the race with 43% support. Incumbent Republican Frank Ginta is at 29%, and independent candidate Sean O'Connor is at 10%. 16% of likely voters polled were undecided. The debate begins at 7 o'clock tonight, live from St. Anselm College in Manchester. Watch it here on WMUR, as well as our website and mobile app. Starting tonight at 5, new information about the long-term effects of sports injuries on players' brains, thanks to a difficult decision from the family former Patriots player Kevin Turner. And holiday sales are in full swing. We'll break down some of the biggest bargains available before Black Friday arrives. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us. Have a great afternoon.